All right, I'm pumped for this one. Apple Brandy on the Rocks by Killian. Here's the thing. I'm kind of an apple brandy snob, all right? This here is one of my all-time favorite fragrances. You know, I didn't get into the brand early on. In fact, more recently, probably this year, maybe end of last year, is when I started collecting Killians. And I'm glad I waited so long because when I first got into fragrances, I was into the freshies. And obviously, if you've smelled any number of Killian scents, you would know that they are usually not freshies. They are heavy and rich scents. And that's what makes me love them so much now. Apple Brandy, going back to it, is so, so good. It reminds me of fall, of autumn. Obviously, I wear it in the wintertime as well. But it's the apple that makes it fall smelling for me, because that's, you know, kind of apple orchards and stuff in the fall time, but with a booziness and a sweetness and a richness, and it's one of my favorites. It's actually one of the first Killians that I smelled. I sampled it first. Someone was gracious enough to send me a little sample of it, and I loved it for years, and then I finally was like, you know what, I need to get some of these. I want to make videos on them. You guys always ask why I didn't do videos on these. And I just wanted to start collecting them, so one of the first ones I bought was Apple Brandy. I bought, I believe it was Apple Brandy and then Straight to Heaven at the same time from their website. So I just kind of did two-in-one deal to get the collection rolling, and it's been down the rabbit hole since then, and I have quite a bit of them. Actually, over on my channel memberships, I'm going to be doing a first impressions on Straight to Heaven Oud and Musk Special Blend, which is a limited edition. Don't believe you can find it anywhere in the United States right now. It came out, I want to say, in May or just earlier this year. I'm going to be doing a first impressions on that one. Super excited to try it out, and I'm so glad to own it. So if you want to watch that, join up to the memberships to the Chaos Eau de Parfum tier, and then you will get access to bonus videos like that, which aren't going to make it here on this channel. And I also want to thank my Chaos Parfum members up over here in the corner. I appreciate hanging out with you guys, chatting with you on Discord, and just kind of being able to help people out a little bit more one-on-one. If you guys want to chat with me and the other members privately in a Discord and just also get access to a bunch of other perks and giveaways and stuff, make sure you join up. All right, enough of it. Let's go ahead and crack this open, and we will get underway with smelling this one. Again, I'm pumped. So the brand of Killian was kind enough to send this one out to me along with Lovert, I believe is how you say it, probably not, but they launched these two at the same time. And of course I said, I would love to check them out. And here it is. So big thank you to the brand. I've supported the channel here a couple of times and I love it, man. So this bottle, of course, looks amazing. It kind of looks like a glass of your favorite liquor, in this case, apple brandy. Let's go ahead and spray this one on and see what it's all about. Nice atomization on these. Let's see, does it smell like the OG? And it definitely does, definitely does. Up top, you get that bright apple type of smell. What's interesting between the two, so Apple Brandy and On the Rocks, neither fragrance has apple listed as a note, and it's unique, but the way they blend these is they blend it in a way with the woods and the boozy notes to make an apple accord come across, even though they're not really using an apple. It's very cool. So one thing I notice with On the Rocks here as I'm spraying it on is there's a bit more of a juicy vibrance. So the original is a bit more syrupy, dense, heavy, thick, sweet, and woody right off the opening, and it maintains that throughout the entirety of the scent. It's a very rich, dense scent. This one has a bit more of a bright juiciness, a bit more of a vibrance, while of course still maintaining that apple brandy DNA. So let's go ahead and take a look at the note breakdown. Up top we have pineapple, bergamot, cardamom. In the mid, we have rum, vanilla, moss. In the base, ambroxan, and cedar. So what I'm getting from here is probably a little bit of a combination of that pineapple. I think that's going to be adding the syrupiness that I'm getting. Because again, remember, the original is very syrupy. It doesn't have any of those notes listed though, but it has a very heavy syrupiness. And this one still has that, probably coming from the pineapple. Some of that brightness I would expect is coming from maybe the bergamot, but also probably some of the ambroxan, because you got to remember ambroxan, you know, people equate that to blue shower gel, and so people may see ambroxan in this and think, oh, it smells like a blue fragrance now. That couldn't be further from the truth. Ambroxan, of course, there's different ways, different forms to use it, but a lot of times what it does is it gives off a warm fuzziness, you know, kind of gives off a bright, sparkling nature. And that's probably what I'm picking up on here. If you've never smelled Ambroxan before, get a bottle of Molecule 2 by Eccentric Molecules and smell that, and then you will see kind of what you would expect out of it. I'm for sure getting that rum that's equating to the boozy, brandy smell here. Now, one thing that's cool that I'm picking up on is I'm getting an earthiness, and that smells really nice. It's like an earthiness in the base, probably coming from the oak moss and a little bit of the cedar wood. But it does have that woodiness like the original, but with that vibrant, juicy, sexy opening of that apple brandy smell. Oh, this is so, so good and so exciting. You know, I wasn't really expecting anything like this, but I am excited to see it. You know, apple brandy is always one that I enjoy personally for myself, even though if maybe my girlfriend isn't the biggest fan of it, or if, you know, I'm not wearing it for compliments, it's one that I like to enjoy. And the fact that we get a flanker of this now where I can change it up, and if I want something a bit more bright and playful, maybe even for the daytime, I can go with On the Rocks. But if I want something really dense and heavy and rich and just full on, then I can go for just the original there. I think it's a really nice balance here between the two, where I can see myself using both. They're both concentrated as an eau de parfum, and the original apple brandy is kind of divisive on performance. For me, it's not the strongest Killian that I own, but it does do the trick. I'm excited to see how this one performs here as I test it more moving into fall. But I gotta say, as it sits right now, I'm in love. I mean, I'm biased because I love this DNA, so I knew I was going to like this one if it smelled anything like it, and it does. Just a brighter, juicier, a bit more of a sparkling, fresher, vibrant take on the original. And even though you get that brightness and that juiciness, there's still a little bit of an earthy woodiness in the base, along with, of course, all that rum, and I love it. If the original apple brandy was too much, if it was just too heavy for you and too almost syrupy sweet, then On the Rocks is going to be potentially your solution to that. Again, there's still that syrupy sweetness coming from, I think, how the pineapple is compounded here. But at the same time, you get a nice freshness alongside that. And you, of course, get the counterbalance from the woods and the rum. So I think it kind of evens out a little bit. All in all, super happy with it. So excited to have this one in the collection. And I can't wait to wear it more coming up this fall. I'm going to do a full review on this one and let you know kind of what it's all about, performance and everything, later on. All right, guys, that's going to do it for me. That was my first impressions on Apple Brandy On the Rocks. Stunning fragrance. It's going to be a killer scent this fall. I will link it up down below if you want to grab it. Again, big thank you to the brand for getting these out to me. Really appreciate the support, and I appreciate your guys' support as well. Stay safe, stay healthy. We'll see you tomorrow with another one. Take care.